Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Let me take a moment to thank each one of you for liking my first video. I'll keep trying my level best to provide the most insightful videos about 3D lighting. Now, taking a cue from our last video, this time we will be emphasizing more towards the differences in lights, shadows and color as for the different times of the day. We will also discuss how some places develop a distinct look due to its surrounding environment. If you remember from our last video, we have considered sun as a direct source of light and sky as an indirect source of light. Henceforth, we may consider our direct light, which is the sun, as a key light, and the indirect light, which is the sky, as a fill light. Key light happens to be the most dominating light in a scene and a primary source by which a background or a character appears lit. Key light generally casts fairly prominent shadows, which are visible on the opposite side of an object from the light source. A shadow appears in the areas where the light rays were unable to reach, as they were obstructed by an object in between. Before we move any further, there is a golden rule in lighting which I always follow, which is: smaller the light, sharper the shadows; larger the light, softer the shadows. We will see this phenomenon being repeated n number of times. If we consider sun as our key light, it is comparatively having a smaller source, but the intensity is much higher. Hence, we see shadows being cast on the opposite side of an object which is lit by the sunlight. We will see the distinct properties of sunlight and its shadows being replicated in softwares like Maya and 3D Max in a much more detailed way. Moving on to the indirect source of light, which is the sky, we will call it a fill light. The main reason of sky being called as so lies in its name itself. Sky having a large coverage like the large hemisphere, illuminating each and every object below it. Since the illumination is spread equally and uniformly, it helps illuminate those shadow areas where key lights could not reach. So basically, it fills up all the shadows with its skylight. This is the reason we are able to see an object even on the opposite side of a sunlight, since it is visible due to the skylight covering the shadow areas from all directions. Let us try figuring out why we don't see shadows being cast by skylight if it is coming from all the directions. Well, the answer lies in the golden rule of lighting, which is: smaller the light, sharper the shadows; larger the light, softer the shadows. Skylight, being a large source of light, casts such soft and diffuse shadows that they are not at all noticeable. Hence, we happen to see the shadows being cast by the sunlight and not the skylight. If we had lots of tiny lights or smaller lights covering an object, then it will replicate a player in a stadium or a football field, which has comparatively smaller yet powerful lights covering an entire ground from all the sides. We see sharp shadows in all the directions being cast by the spotlights. In the following example, we will be clearly witnessing the concept of key light and fill light. In its practical implementation, if we notice the photos of the astronaut on the moon, we only see the areas which are illuminated by the sunlight. But if we try to see in the shadow areas, we are unable to see anything in it. It means that due to the lack of atmosphere on the moon, there is no skylight. And if there is no skylight, there is no illumination in the areas falling under the key light shadow. So to see what happens if there is only key light in an environment, the moon is the best example to study. On the other hand, if we see the same astronaut images when he is on the planet Earth, we see skylight filling up the shadow areas and revealing everything which could not be covered by the sun, that is the key light. The photos we have seen also shows the distinct difference of lighting on Earth and Moon, where we can see sunlight having a clearly white light without any dispersion due to lack of atmosphere, as we have discussed in our previous video, whereas on our planet Earth, atmosphere plays a large role in emission of colors after the sunlight reaches the Earth's surface through the atmosphere. Before we end this video, let us remind ourselves again the golden rule of lighting, which is: smaller the light, sharper the shadows; larger the light, softer the shadows. We will see constant repetition of this phenomenon in every scene we study and observe. I hope this video has clarified the concept of the key light and fill light, and stay tuned for many more videos covering the basics of lighting, which will eventually help us while lighting each and every 3D scene in any given software. Thank you all so much for your support and watching this video. Looking forward to your likes and comments. And to keep knowing more and more about lighting, do subscribe to this channel. Thanks again. Thank you.